Need a backpack because this is how I carry my notes and stuff, and it's not holding up. But yeah, so today, so today again is Friday, the 11th of April. I'm at the library. Muir National Theater. That's who down the block. This is another. This is the Museum of Natural History, I think, which is right across the street. But this museum here is the museum for artists. So it's the art museum, and so I like to explore all different types of libraries, because I find they can solely concentrate in just one
or
subject matter segment of a population, and that's the only information you're going to actually receive in terms of historical events or what actually took place. So my reasons for coming to a library like such as this, the art museum library, is because I want to capture what was actually going on during particular historic times of the years of century past, and find out the artist's particular take on historical events. And so that leads me to from the Viking era to what happened during the Nazi occupation in Norway. What was actually the artist depicting, and what were the artists trying to communicate through their work? So that's pretty much why I chose to do a lot of my research here, as well as other different points of subject matters and information. Because I go to the Law Museum, which is down the block. I go also to the regular university library, which has a lot of historical books from the 17 and 1800s that rarely you find within America. So, I'm lucky to be here. But today, I actually woke up very early, and I went to a place that on Fridays they give away free food. So I went there, and I arrived there probably about, I want to say, 7:15. Last week I went there about the same time, probably right there about 7:30. And last week when I got there, I was number 14, but some odd reason there was this big commotion. This man was behind me, kept hitting me, like trying to get my attention, but very violently, and so much so that I asked the people, can I stand next to them, like, just to have a barrier between me and the person behind me. I'll insert some pictures so you can see that was last week.
So this is a person that was hitting me from behind, like violently tapping me, if you want to call it tapping, on my shoulder, trying to get my attention, yet speaking to me in English. And I'm thinking, well, why would you speak to someone you don't know if they're English or not, or speaking, well, you know what I mean. Why would you choose that language when it's not the predominant language of the place? So yeah, I just wanted to make sure I got that on tape. Oh, look, and there are the handlers. Handler or either agent. And, yep, agent. Handlers, whatever.
In any event, by the time I did get a number and get to the front, I was number 14, I was number 34, something or other. And by the time I actually got in food, I was only given some bread and I think one meal or something like that, like one of those microwave meals for the week. Today, they up the ante,
really.
And she put them on, she wasn't here. there is. So I told her, I was talking to him, and he was giving up a ticket, and I was like, actually, before I can even finish my sentence, let's just tell him I was here at 7:15. He says, actually, no, they said you weren't. And I was like, wow, that's interesting, because the prior week's past, he didn't speak any English, but he could muster that pretty well. So I was like, fine, no problem. Picked my bag, put it on my shoulder, and just went back. You know, 3 hours of waiting in the freezing cold from 7 until 10:30 or so, and not even to get anything. So I was like, that's interesting. Meanwhile, you're being circled constantly with the police. And then these agents who they have throughout the line situated there are constantly hitting me or finding reasons to bump into me, standing behind me pulling my hair, which is another thing. I used to have like beads and feathers in my hair. I have to tie it really tight now because they will stand behind me and they will pull my hair and like pull the feathers I have in my hair. They would take them out. I don't know why. I mean, maybe they're keeping them as a souvenir. So I don't have any more feathers to put in my hair. So that was going on for the past 3 hours of waiting outside. And so when he comes and he says that, no, they said you weren't here and we skipped warning or something like that. I guess he just thought I was going to like get into this big altercation of still arguing. I was like, dude, it's been 3 hours. I'm thinking to myself. I just grabbed my purse, my candy bag, and put it on my shoulder and just walked away. So I was like, it's not worth it. Really? You just want to make sure that I don't have anything to eat, to go through all of that trouble so I don't have anything to eat. So I was like, fine, let me just grab my things and I'll just leave. Enjoy.